Dear students, today we are in the field of rapeseed mustard crop that is also comes under oilseed brassicas, in which I can tell you that you come nearer, you can see the Nagaharu. You can see here the Nagaharu U1935 has given U triangle. Has given U triangle. Is it seen here?
Yes, sir.
Has given U triangle, which is known as U triangle. Demonstrated the genomic relationship among primary diploid species and naturally derived amphidiploid species. The crop which we are cultivating at present, mainly the particularly the what you call the Indian mustard, Brassica jansia, this is naturally derived amphidiploid. If you see primary diploid, if you see that in triangle, Brassica nigra, which is also known as black mustard or Banarsi rye, this is having n is equal to 8, having BB genome. Whereas if you talk about Brassica campestris, which is now known as Brassica rapa, is n is equal to 10 and having AA genome. In this you are getting three crops: Toria, yellow sarso and brown sarso. And you see the Brassica oleracea, which is having n is equal to 9, is having CC genome. But here these are coal crops. Coal crops are coming in this. So these are three basic you can say, primary you can say, diploid species, from where you are having amphidiploid by cross of this Brassica nigra into Brassica rapa. In natural condition, they have crossed each other and they got haploid plant, and which was then diploid, naturally diploid, and that has become derived amphidiploid. Here you can see the Brassica jansia, where we are here standing. This is Brassica jansia crop. These different varieties are here. The main, you can see here, you come here please. You can see here in eastern UP at present, in normally sown condition, the Brassica jansia, which is also known as Indian mustard, or it is also known as mustard, or it is also known as rye. This is the main oilseed crop. Nowadays in this area, and particularly in eastern UP, you can see the normal sown condition. In normal sown condition, this is the best variety among in the farmer's field nowadays. This is the best released variety in the farmer's field. Now you can say the variety which is in the pipeline, which was earlier bred by the Birsa Agriculture University. When I had been in Birsa Agriculture University, I bred this material, Birsa Shivam, that could not be released till now, unfortunately, because of my shifting from Birsa Agriculture University Ranchi to BHU Varanasi. So you see, you can compare it, the difference between these two. It is taking around 12 to 15 days earlier than that, and vigorous plant than that, and high yielder. It has been already for many years, it has been checked here also. So this is in the pipeline, the Birsa Shivam bred by Birsa Agriculture University. When I had been in Birsa Agriculture University, I bred this variety. The another variety, this is also released variety. This was released in 2005 as early mustard in Jharkhand. Still it is prevailing in Jharkhand. If you are showing in delayed condition also, this is doing well, excellent. In delayed showing also, this is performing well. In rain fed condition also it is doing well. So still it is continuing in Jharkhand. It was notified by the government of India, Shivani. It was notified by the government of India in 2005. So now you can see that how these naturally derived amphidiploids you have received. These are the varieties in Indian mustard. So of course the Brassica jonesia, this Indian mustard is derived by crossing between Brassica nigra and Brassica rapa, whereas Brassica napus, the another crop, this is also known as gophi sarso, this is also known as rape. This has been developed naturally, you can say, by cross between Brassica oleracea and Brassica rapa. Of course, this is giving you the canola oil. This is also called as 00 lines. This Brassica napus is called 00 line. Of course, the yield potential here in India, it is very low. But oil quality is canola type, is very good oil quality is here. See the Brassica carinata. Brassica carinata is also known as Karan Rai. It is also Ethiopian mustard, known as Ethiopian mustard. This is Brassica carinata. N is equal to 17, which is having BB and CC genome. BB genome from here, Nigra, and CC genome from Oleracea. So you can see here. And here in Brassica napus, you have seen the CC genome from Oleracea and AA genome from Rapa. So altogether, there are in India, altogether in rapeseed mustard, about eight crops are being cultivated in India. So all these crops, if you want to see, come nearer a little. The origin, if you the origin of most of the Brassicas are believed to be the Mediterranean region. What are the crops being here cultivated in India? Indian mustard, or mustard or rye, which you are seeing here. The another is Toria, which you have seen in this Brassica rapa. In Toria, brown sarso, yellow sarso, these three are Brassica rapa. Then black mustard you have seen in U triangle. The gobi sarso you have seen in U triangle. The Karan Rai or Ethiopian mustard you have seen in the U triangle itself. The another added is Taramira. Of course, it is not oilseed Brassicas. This is another species, genus, is Taramira, but it has been included in oilseed Brassicas. It is having EE genome, 2N is equal to 22. So, dear students, something more I would like to tell you here. In India, you can say this is the major oilseed Brassicas. This Indian mustard rye is the major oilseed Brassica. Next to this, you can get, of course, this is the highest yielding in India. In oilseed Brassicas, this is the highest yielding crop. Next to this, the next to this in yield potential, you can say the yellow sarso. That is highly sensitive to different diseases. So that is why the yield potential is also lesser than this. That is, of course, this is taking around 120 to 125 days in maturity. And if you see the yellow sarso, that is taking around 85 to 90 days, or maybe 100 days in maturity, yellow sarso. Then if you talk about Toria and brown sarso, they are taking around 75 to 85 days depending upon the location where you are growing it. Of course, the yield potential of Toria and brown sarso, they are very low yielder. Of course, because of the duration also, they are taking 75 to 85 days around. So altogether, you have seen the crops. Brassica napus, as I said, that is giving low yield in India. Of course, in other developed countries and developing countries, in oilseed Brassicas, this Brassica napus is the major edible oil seed crop, you can say, because of the canola oil quality of that oil in Brassica napus. So I wanted to discuss you about today about the artificial hybridization in case of alcid brassicas. In that, I would like to first explain the, floral biology. We must discuss about the floral biology, then only we can go for artificial hybridization. We can stop now.